Israel has deployed tanks and troops to its border with Gaza, as it mulls whether to launch a ground operation in the territory after days of violence. Conflict raged throughout Thursday as Palestinian militants fired rockets into Israel and the Israeli army maintained a barrage of airstrikes. More than 100 people have been killed in Gaza and 7 have died in Israel. Jewish and Israeli Arab mobs have also been fighting within Israel, prompting the president to warn of civil war. Defense Minister Benny Gantz ordered a massive reinforcement of security forces to suppress the internal unrest, and more than 400 people were arrested. Two infantry units and one armored unit were positioned near the border with Gaza on Thursday. At least 7,000 army reservists have also been called up. No decision has yet been made on whether to launch a ground operation. The Israeli army is expected to put forward plans for a possible offensive imminently, but it would need to be approved by army chiefs and various levels of government. The 4 days of violence in Gaza and Israel is the worst since 2014. It was initially fueled by weeks of Israeli-Palestinian tension in East Jerusalem, which led to clashes at a holy site revered by both Muslims and Jews. This spiraled into an incessant exchange of Palestinian rocket fire and Israeli airstrikes. In other developments on Thursday, three rockets were fired from Lebanon into the sea off the coast of northern Israel, the Israel Defense Forces, IDF, said. No group said they were responsible, but several militant groups operate in Lebanon, including Hezbollah, which fought a month-long war with Israel in 2006. Israel's military said it had hit targets in Gaza that included intelligence buildings and homes and businesses used by militants, the Palestinian militant group Hamas. Meanwhile, fired further barrages of rockets towards Israel from Gaza, and a spokesman for the group said it had shown only a small part of its capabilities. Further violence broke out between Jewish and Israeli Arab groups in mixed towns and cities within Israel. International airlines, including KLM, British Airways and Virgin Atlantic, have suspended services to Israel. Incoming flights were also diverted south from Tel Aviv's main airport. Thank you for watching. This is Silvermarky TV. Please subscribe, like, share and comment, and also hit the notification bell icon to notify for more videos to be uploaded.
זה דבר שאנחנו לא יכולים לקבל.